A wise man once said that necessity is the mother of invention. We have shown how in the beginning cavemen could communicate verbally, but when the need for long-distance communication arose, several techniques such as smoke signal, pigeons, pony express, semaphore flag, etc. were developed. But they were not enough. The desire for fast and reliable communication gave birth to wireless communication using radio waves. It wasn't easy in the beginning for ITUR. Unlike wired communication, it was very difficult to establish a full-fledged communication system and govern them. In first generation, the goal was to provide a rich wireless experience. But it was not matured enough to provide a smooth service. As the technology grew, the organizations from different countries came together to achieve global connectivity, and second generation wireless communication was developed. The need for higher data rate resulted in evolution to third generation and fourth generation, as this channel is purely dedicated to advanced communication, which is fourth generation. Here we will broadly cover the underlying technologies, which are used in air interfaces like OFDMA, SCFDMA, TDD, FDD. We will also discuss how spectrums are allocated to telecom operators and how operators distribute the bandwidth among the users. We will show you how frames are structured and how throughput is calculated in different radio conditions. Once we have brief idea about the underlying technologies, we will dive deep into LTE architecture, where we will discuss the different nodes and the different protocols that are used in LTE. We will also discuss different LTE states and identifiers. In the later part, we will discuss LTE procedures such as the attach, detach, cell reselection and handover, where we will discuss authentication, NAS and RRC security, policy and charging, service data flow and bearer level QoS. So friends, fasten your belts for a ride through the world of long-term evolution. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Happy learning!